My house is in a terrible state, and I expect they will be a bit shocked by it.
I would much rather go and take some fuchsia cuttings and get the Hoover out. Sometimes I just think it looks too awful even for me to bear, and so I have to do something about it.
The nation's dream cleaners, Aggie McKenzie and Kim Woodburn, are on a mission to teach Britain how to clean and get Britain cleaning. There's nothing these domestic doyens don't know about cleaning, but today they face an unholy challenge. Janet Lamb is an organic farmer from Kent who claims that her farmhouse hasn't seen the end of a duster since she moved in 9 years ago.
Now, come on, see what's walking into, Aggie.
Oh, God.
Damp dogs, isn't it?
Oh, my God, isn't this true?
Janet complains housework makes her bad-tempered, and while she may be a whiz in her wellies, her house is a temple of neglect.
You ever heard of perfume evening in Paris? Because this dear's nice in a dustbin.
Oh, that is foul. That is sour. That is disgusting.
Take a gander at the sink, dear.
Never mind dusting. Janet hasn't done any cleaning.
Oh, God. Oh, look, this is the prize one. Watch.
Oh,
and look, up
God.
Here.
It's hard to see where the farmyard stops and the house starts.
Look at this. Everything meets your expectations here, doesn't it?
The farmyard theme doesn't stop at the kitchen.
Doesn't look very inviting for a living room, does it?
Full of dirt.
It's just grime everywhere.
Cat food, dog food. Oh, I like this touch, the air freshener behind. As if that was going to make any difference.
And look at all this muck from the wood here. It's honestly, it's like... It's
do you know
outside,
what? I
isn't
am...
it?
Oh, I'm not... Oh.
Oh,
look, Aggie.
It's awful.
If you, we, oh.
It's awful.
I can't even get this up. It's got ingrained constantly going around this house. Look.
How can anyone allow the place to get into this state?
I just do not know where to start. It is just a tip. I do admit it's a tip.
It's a bit embarrassing, really. Occasionally, if I start clearing up, she'll help me for 10 minutes, and then she'll go, oof, exhausted, and sit down and read her paper.
As far as my wife's concerned, I think she would much prefer to invite my mother over to our house as opposed to us eating here.
Look at this tip.
Every single room is a human compost heap with a stink to match.
Well, let's move on.
See what else we've got. Oh my God, it's not very nice, is
it? But actually, would you believe?
Kim, I'm a bit frightened of all those horrible.
Don't like that.
No.
Don't like that.
Nasty.
That is dried
I don't like
in...
any of this.
No,
either.
That's dried in urine. This is years of it. Mm-hmm. It's horrible. Okay.
Janet being Janet and being on her own, she doesn't have the pressure that society or maybe husbands or relatives put on you so that you have to have this rather clean and tidy home. And I suppose she's just reverting to being... Well, slob's a horrid word, but something not too far from that.
I love growing things. I mean, a Hoover is just a Hoover, isn't it? It never produces a flower or has a baby or... Outside things do, they do things.
It's time for Kim and Aggie to meet this filth offender.
This is the plan of action, Janet.
Right,
you're listening.
This
mess is going to be cleaned up. We're going to strip this room out of all everything you've got in it, right?
Yes.
Are you listening to me?
Yes, I am.
This is dreadful. You know it's dreadful, don't you?
Yes, it's awful.
We'll be able to see through the windows when we leave here. That'll be a novelty, won't it?
Yes, it will.
We're going to wash the curtains. Oh, you admit it, do you? It's going to be ashamed. Floor scrubbed, carpet shampooed. All the food out, that's your job. All the out-of-date stuff thrown. We don't want to see it.
Bin.
We are going to clean that fridge.
It's disgraceful. It's horrible.
Then we go into that lounge.
Yes.
We do the same in there. Then you and I... You hearing this?
Yes, I am, Kim, yes.
Don't be shocked.
No.
We're going up to your bathroom.
Are we?
We are, dear. I'm going to supply you with gloves. Your nails aren't spoilt. But we are going to clean it without a moan from you.
This gruesome task will be a two-day job. Every room has to be cleared, scrubbed, scraped and steamed free of 9 years' worth of deep, deep dirt. An army of reinforcements is summoned to systematically attack every inch of Janet's filthy home. Into uniform, let the cleaning commence.
Now I'm ready for action.
Oh, the joys of cleaning.
Aggie, get out here. I need your help.
You know, I could be doing other things with my life. Do you realise this?
It's probably the least of our problems.
It's killing my image. It's killing my image. Stone dead. Come on, be ruthless, please. We're trying to do... What is that? Oh, I don't even want to know. Go on.
The food in Janet's pantry is slowly turning into a family heirloom.
We're doing well. What else? How long have you had that?
I don't even know what it is.
Oh, well, put it in.
Packets and jars untouched for years, except by the biscuit beetles, mealworms and moths, which have moved in to feast on foodstuffs which are positively prehistoric.
How long's that been up there?
I don't know. I don't even know what it is.
I mean, look at this.
Looks like flour of some sort, doesn't it? It's probably it looks more like, corn flour.
Looks like dust to me.
You're right.
Oh, look. Oh, please. This is getting... Oh, my Lord.
You know, I think I might have bought that when I was at my last house.
So you've been here 9 years. Yes. Thank you very much. We're going to throw it out.
Well, that's fine, then. I made a collie cheese with that the other day.
Well, I'm not going to take your word for it. Come on.
Honestly,
there's a dead moth in there.
Well, there's nothing wrong with moths, is there?
They lay eggs.
Moths don't hurt anything.
You know, we can't keep it, you know
there's
that.
There's nothing... I can't even get it out. It's buried itself. There you are.